Hey everyone, and welcome to Erica LaBelle TV, where we view biblical Christian perspectives on life and living gospel daily, and where we also promote the growth of spirituality, accountability, and mental wellness in the body of Christ. My name is Erica. So today's video is about why I think it's important for us as humans to love God before we can effectively love anyone else. So when we read the book of Mark chapter 12 verse 30, it says, "And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. This is the first commandment. And the second like it is this: you shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." So these are the commandments that Jesus left us with: to love God with all our hearts and to love our neighbors as ourselves. So the number one reason why I think that we should love God first before we can love anybody else, or before we love anybody else, is because it is a commandment. The first commandment that God has given us as believers is to love Him with all our strength, with all our hearts, and with all our mind. This is not a choice thing where we can debate about it or choose whether we're gonna love God first before we love our husbands or our boyfriends or our girlfriends or our wives. It is a commandment. God has commanded us to love Him with all our hearts and with all our strength and with all our minds. So we are to love God first. If we love God, we love our husbands or our wives. We love our neighbors. And because we love God, we love all the things that God loves, including our enemies. If we put anything above God or love anything or anyone before God, then that thing or person is an idol. God does not want us to place anyone or anything above Him, because He is a jealous God. He wants us to depend on Him and constantly look up to Him instead of things and people. He wants us to learn to depend on Him, because He knows that people and things will fail us. And that's why He wants us to love Him first above everything and everyone. So the number two reason why I think that it's important for us to love God first is that the second commandment says that we should love our neighbors as ourselves. But most of us don't even have love for ourselves. We don't know how to love ourselves. You cannot give what you don't have. If you don't have love in your heart, you cannot give it to your neighbor. Yet the scripture is saying to love your neighbor as yourself. Like the first one, it isn't a choice where we get to choose if we're going to love our neighbors or not. It's a commandment. So we have to love our neighbors as ourselves. But most of the times, we don't even have love for ourselves. If you don't have love for yourself, how can you love your neighbor? You cannot give to your neighbor what you do not have. How do we learn to love our neighbors, especially the unlovable neighbor, the one who is so difficult and challenging to love? The best place to fill yourself up with love is with God. That's why God wants us to love Him first, because in loving God first, we learn what love is. God expressing His love to us, showing us how much He loves us, teaches us what love is. He expresses His love to us and He pours His love in us. And when we are filled with God's love, we can give that love back to our neighbors. God is the author of love. He created love. He created us just to express His love to us. We cannot learn how to love from anyone or anything apart from God. So nobody can love us more than God. When we go to God, He loves on us and He shows us grace and mercy. He shows us agape love. He shows us unconditional love. And when He shows us unconditional love, He wants us to extend that same unconditional love to our neighbor. If we sit at Jesus' feet, if we go to God and God teaches us how to love, that is how we are going to be able to love our difficult neighbor. We are normally very selfish human beings. And we're always thinking about our gain. You know, what am I going to gain from loving this person? What am I going to gain from caring about this person or helping this person? What am I going to gain for praying for this person? We always want something in return, but unconditional love has no conditions attached to it. Jesus teaches us unconditional love. Nobody else can teach us unconditional agape love like Jesus does. God is saying that love even your enemies. Imagine knowing somebody has done you so wrong and yet God is saying to love them. It's so hard. But when we love God first, God's love humbles us. We see how God is so merciful to us in spite of our weaknesses. We are so evil. We are so wicked at heart, but He still loves us. If God, who is so perfect, who has no blemish and no sin in Him, can look at sinners like us, if God, who is the Alpha and Omega, loves us in spite of our weaknesses and our wrongs, it teaches us mercy and compassion. It teaches us humility. We see how we are unworthy of His love and still He chooses to love us. We see that we are not perfect, but His love makes us perfect. We are made perfect in His love. Love is not automatic, it's developed. And when we're constantly loving on God, we're developing love. When it comes to giving love, we human beings are normally biased and very selective of whom we love. We just want to love the ones that loves us back, the ones who reciprocate the love that we give them. But God has commanded us to love our neighbors. The scripture did not say love your neighbors that loves you as well, or love the neighbor who has similar values and views as yourself, or love the neighbor who agrees with you. It said love your neighbor, period. And that was it. Love your neighbor. Your neighbor is that annoying co-worker at work whom you only tolerate because you have to work with them. You have to work in the same space and environment as them. Your neighbor is that gay or bisexual person whom you hate and disregard and look down upon because in your eyes they are living a sinful life. God says love them. It might be very difficult to love people who aren't like you, people who hold different views and values and with different views and beliefs and religion, people who live their lives outside of the word of God. But God says not to judge them, but to love them. Jesus says that loving others shows that we are indeed His disciples. If people are toxic, you can distance yourself from them. But God is not calling you to judge them. You don't have to be in connection with that person. But you can pray for that person because you love them and you want them to be better. You want them to be a better person. Number three reason why we should love God first is because nobody can love us more than God loves us. There is a certain love that we need from God which nobody and nothing can give to us but God. And when we're not getting that love from God, we have this void within us and we might try to fill that void with alcohol, with pets, with people, with places, with things. Yet when all is said and done, we will find that we are still empty within, because that void can only be filled by God. If we don't go to God to fill that void, we will be looking to fill that void with all the wrong things and in all the wrong places. And that's when we get abused. That's when we get hurt. That's where we get disappointed. That's where we get rejected. When the very person that can fill that void is God. No one else can take the place of God in our lives. Finally, number four reason why we should love God first before we love anyone or anything else is because the love of God is the only love that will last forever. We will all leave this earth one day, but our souls carries on, and it is the relationship that we have with God that will live on forever. Everything on this earth is temporary. The relationships that we have, the things that we buy, the things and the people that we come to love, adore and cherish so much are temporary. But the love of God is forever. The relationships that we have will end. Every relationship that we establish on this earth, every relationship that we found on this earth will end in this world when we leave this world. The only relationship that lasts forever is the relationship that we have with God. So that is the only love that will last forever. It's the love that God has for us that will last forever. Every other love will fade away. Every other love will end. But God's love for us will never end. The love that people have for you will change, but God's love will never change, but it will change you.